Subscribe and hit the notification bell icon for future videos. We're in a battle in this world. We may not see it, we might forget it is there. But the enemy would love nothing more than to start our year off with discouragement and defeat, bringing fear and stress. If you're a believer who is living like salt and light in a dark world, you won't go for long without encountering spiritual warfare. Obstacles and attacks he'll hurl your direction. God reminds us in his word to stay aware of Satan's schemes, to live alert in this world, and to stay close to him. He arms us with the sword, the word of God, to stand against the enemy's lies. He equips us with strength, wisdom, and discernment through his own spirit to stay strong in the spiritual warfare battle. He invites us to spend time in his presence through prayer and worship, pressing in to know him more. As we grow to know God's truth and what is real, we also know more what is false, and we are stronger to stand against it in the powerful name of Jesus. He never leaves us to fend for ourselves in a dark world, but reminds us he is constantly with us, fighting for us, even when we cannot see. Praying God's words back to him is a powerful weapon against the forces of evil. It is truth going out. It reminds us that God knows our way and understands what we face today. It builds our faith and our trust in God. It guards our hearts and focuses our minds back on him. It wins the battle. Prayer plus God's word equals power. Here are 31 spiritual warfare scriptures to read, pray, and memorize. James 4, verse 7. Submit yourselves to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. 1 John 4, verse 4. You are from God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he who is in you than he who is in the world. 2 Corinthians 10, verse 3-5. For though we live in the world, we do not wage war as the world does. The weapons we fight with are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds. We demolish arguments and every pretension that sets itself up against the knowledge of God, and we take captive every thought to make it obedient to Christ. 1 Peter 5, verse 8 and 9. Be self-controlled and alert. Your enemy the devil prowls around like a roaring lion looking for someone to devour. Resist him, standing firm in the faith. Isaiah 54, verse 17. No weapon that is formed against you will prosper, and every tongue that accuses you in judgment you will condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their vindication is from me, declares the Lord. Ephesians 6, verse 11-17. Put on the full armor of God, so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore put on the full armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything, to stand. Stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Romans 8, verse 37. In all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 57. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Zechariah 4, verse 6. Not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord of hosts. 2 Thessalonians 3, verse 3. But the Lord is faithful, and he will strengthen you and protect you from the evil one. Luke 10, verse 19. Behold, I have given you authority to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall hurt you. John 10, verse 10. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly. Matthew 18, verse 18 and 19. Truly I tell you, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Again, truly I tell you that if two of you on earth agree about anything they ask for, it will be done for them by my Father in heaven. Deuteronomy 28, verse 7. The Lord will cause your enemies who rise against you to be defeated before you. They shall come out against you one way and flee before you seven ways. John 16, verse 33. I have told you these things, so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble. But take heart, I have overcome the world. 1 Corinthians 10, verse 13. No temptation has overtaken you except what is common to mankind. And God is faithful, he will not let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. But when you are tempted, he will also provide a way out so that you can endure it. John 8, verse 32. And you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Romans 12, verse 21. Do not be overcome with evil, but overcome evil with good. Revelation 12, verse 11. And they have conquered him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, for they love not their lives even unto death. 1 Timothy 6, verse 12. Fight the good fight of the faith. Take hold of the eternal life to which you were called when you made your good confession in the presence of many witnesses. Matthew 16, verse 18. On this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. 1 John 3, verse 8. The reason the Son of God appeared was to destroy the devil's work.
Isaiah 40, verse 31.
But they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength, they shall mount up with wings like eagles, they shall run and not be weary, they shall walk and not faint. Joshua 23, verse 10. One of your men puts to flight 1,000, for the Lord your God is he who fights for you, just as he promised you. Deuteronomy 3, verse 22. Do not fear them, for the Lord your God is the one fighting for you. Romans 8, verse 31. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who is against us? Psalm 44, verse 5. Through you we will push back our adversaries, for your name we will trample down those who rise up against us. Joshua 1, verse 9. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not tremble or be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Psalm 18, verse 39. For you have girded me with strength for battle, you have subdued under me those who rose up against me. Psalm 91, verse 1-4. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. Surely he will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. 2 Chronicles 20, verse 15. This is what the Lord says to you. Do not be afraid or discouraged because of this vast army. For the battle is not yours, but God's. When we belong to Christ, the enemy never has the final word over our lives. We are secure in God's hands. Never held back by fear or defeat. The battle belongs to the Lord, and he has the final victory. Here is a small prayer for you. Dear God, today we put on the full armor to guard our lives against attack. We put on the belt of truth to protect against lies and deception. We put on the breastplate of righteousness to protect our hearts from the temptations we battle. We put the gospel of peace on our feet, so we're ready to take your light wherever you send us this day. We choose to walk in the peace and freedom of your spirit and not be overcome with fear and anxious thoughts. We take up your shield of faith that will extinguish all the darts and threats hurled our way by the enemy. We believe in your power to protect us and choose to trust in you. We put on the helmet of salvation, which covers our minds and thoughts, reminding us we are children of the day, forgiven, set free, saved by the grace of Christ Jesus. We take up the sword of the Spirit, your very word, the one offensive weapon given to us for battle, which has the power to demolish strongholds, alive, active, and sharper than any double-edged sword. We ask for your help in remembering to put on your full armor every day, for you give us all that we need to stand firm in this world. Forgive us, God, for the times we've been unprepared, too busy to care, or trying to fight and wrestle in our own strength. Thank you that we never fight alone, for you are constantly at work on our behalf, shielding, protecting, strengthening, exposing deeds of darkness, bringing to light what needs to be known, covering us from the cruel attacks we face even when we're unaware. In the powerful name of Jesus, amen. Please rate the video, comment, share, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell icon for future videos. And if you want to support this channel, you can click on the join button below. The video is free to use on your channel without giving me any credit. God bless you all.